You guys have questions about this homework, and I would like to go over this. This is for homework 2.3C, number 11. So in this question, we try to evaluate the limit if it exists. If an answer does not exist, we enter DNE. So we try to find this limit over here. Now notice first notice that if I plug in negative 4, if I do a direct substitution, plugging negative 24 into x, I'm going to end up with 0 over 0. This type of limit, we call it an indeterminate form, so which means we need to investigate a little bit further before we can jump into any conclusion. Okay, so it's indeterminate. Okay, now this one over here, we see that you have this radical sign over here, okay, and then you have this radical subtracting this 25. Remember in the lesson I gave, we say to deal with this type of indeterminate form, okay, one way to do it is to rationalize it. So we times the conjugate of this one. The conjugate of this is you change this subtraction here into addition, okay? So these two are conjugate. So we times the conjugate of this, okay? Up and down, okay? So whatever you multiply up here, you need to multiply down here, okay? Now, once you have done this, then notice that the different the two square formula. A minus B times A plus B is A square minus B square. So we get the square of this, think about this as A minus B and A plus B. When they multiply, we get the square of this, okay, which is this, minus the square of 25 right here. And the denominator, you just copy it down. Now, when you square this, the square root and square over here will cancel, and that would give us x squared plus 49. And I'm subtracting the square of 25 right here. Now, when we get to this, when we simplify this, this becomes x squared minus 576. And now this number is a little bit big, but I don't know if you guys can recognize it. The key part over here is, if you can recognize this one here, it's a square of 24. So you can try to take the square root of this. That's equal to 24. So if you can recognize this is the square of 24, then that will help you to solve this problem, because this is a different than two square, x squared minus 24 squared. So use the different two square formula, we factor this different two square into x plus 24 times x minus 24. By doing this, then we see this x plus 24 is a common factor. So we can divide out this common factor. Once you divide out this common factor, we are no longer in 0 over 0 indeterminate form. So because the factor that causes 0 over here is divide out, right? Okay. So now we end up with this x minus 24 over this expression right here. Now we can do a direct substitution, okay? Because negative 24 now is in the domain of this function now, okay? It's not gonna make the denominator equal to 0. So substitute negative 24 into x right here, you get negative 48 in the numerator. Down here, square negative 24 plus 49, that's 625. The square root of 625 is 25. And then plus another 25 over here, that's 50. Now, when you reduce this, they'll get negative 24 over 25. And that's the final answer over here. All right, I hope this helps.